Good afternoon from the most beautiful campus in the United States, Ringe, America, home of the Franklin Pierce Football Ravens. And we're coming to you here from on signing day, February the 3rd, one of the funnest and most cool days that we have of the year as we get to introduce new members to our football family. Our staff is incredibly excited. I would like to thank our staff for the incredible amount of hours and hard work that have gone into putting this class together. We feel like this now at our third recruiting class since I took over and we started the Division II football program here, that we really feel like this is the class that kind of puts the icing on the cake. My first two classes have built a really solid foundation, and we're just really super excited about adding this group of guys to our team in the hopes that we can be really super competitive in our league and have a chance to win our league very shortly. So this is a very exciting day for us on campus, and we're doing this video a little bit different than what we've done in the past due to the fact that we're not going to be having a national signing day party or be able to get together in person. So kind of what you're going to see is kind of a longer type of video where we're able to talk about the state of our program, introduce the guys that are signed to our football team, have highlight videos, some videos of the guys talking about why they chose our awesome school and our football program. And so this one should be a unique and fun experience for our fans and our football family. So I'd like to start off with first recognizing the seniors that we have graduating this spring. Obviously, we're all incredibly disappointed that we were not able to have a football season this year. And these four guys have been really exemplary members of our football team, not only on the field, but in the classroom and in the Raven football community. So I'd like to personally thank Lo Jackson, Sekou Villard, Jared Lupus, and Avril Kennedy for what they've been able to do for our football team. I'm sorry they're not going to be able to play a game this year, which is really tough. I know a lot of people are going through this, but I want to just personally thank those guys first. So obviously right now our football team is back on campus. We have roughly 80 guys working out every day, getting stronger, bigger, faster, spending time in the weight room. Obviously, spring is a time of personal growth and personal development. And while there's obviously been some tough parts with this year, we've been able to take a young football team and get a year older, and a year bigger, and a year stronger. So we're excited about the work that the guys are doing. And, you know, we will eventually have some version of a spring practice schedule. And possibly a couple of competition type of things later on in the spring, but obviously not what any of us had hoped for this year. So, but obviously right now, we are in a position of developing and getting ready really for the fall of 21 season, when our group of, recruits will be joining us. So in this signing class, what did we have to address? Obviously now we've been on campus for 2 years. We've been able to kind of see and start to build a foundation of our football team, but be able to see kind of now what are some of the missing pieces that we've had to deal with. We really went into this class with two things. We haven't addressed the defensive line. We've lost a couple members in that group. Our numbers are not quite yet what we need to be at to be really super competitive in the inning 10. And so you're going to see a really dominating class of defense alignment that we're able to sign this year. And we're incredibly proud of that group of guys that we were able to get. And then second of all, we hired Coach Washington, our new offensive coordinator, back in the summer. And as we got here, we really felt like we needed to address the offensive skill position speed. And so we're going to have a couple of guys that we feel like are going to be really dynamic just from a pure overall foot speed perspective. But in addition to that, being able to make plays when the ball's in the air. And so we feel like we've been able to address both of those things. Overall, our class is going to be made up of three offensive linemen and two receivers on the offensive side of the ball. We have not gone out and had to address the quarterback situation, the running back situation, or the tight end situation because we signed great players last year at those positions, and we look forward to seeing them develop. And then we are also going to sign roughly three defensive linemen and then another player who we feel like is a combination edge pass rusher, defensive end type of guy that can be flexible in our 3-4. We're also going to sign one linebacker and either one or two defensive backs. And so really, you know, we're looking at a group of about 11 to 12 players total in this deal that we feel like that, again, is going to be kind of more icing on the cake, guys that have elevated the play at the position groups that they are at. So, again, thank everybody for coming to check out this video. You're going to see a lot of fun things over the next 20 minutes or so. Welcome to National Signing Day here on our campus. Our hashtag this year has been Ravens Rising, and we're really looking forward to seeing what this program looks like in the fall of 21.
Tino Savarinaya, 6'2", 275, D-lineman out of New Jersey. An explosive player with a non-stop motor and a nose for the football. He has a passion for the game, and his excitement for our program gives us no doubt that he will become a big player for us here at Franklin Pierce University.
Hello, Raven family. My name is Tino Savarinaya, and I'm from Fallsburg, New Jersey. I play defensive tackle and nose guard, and I plan on studying psychology when I get to Franklin Pierce. The reason I chose Franklin Pierce is because the coaches were amazing throughout our recruiting process, but the players welcomed me with open arms, and it's definitely just a place to be. What Franklin Pierce is going to get from me, both my coaches and teachers, are a hard worker, a player that's determined, and a player that's very coachable. I can't wait to get up on campus and meet everybody. Go Ravens!
Nicholas Oliveri Chase, 6'4", 235, D-lineman out of Cambridge, Massachusetts. This young man has the frame, build, and explosive playmaking skills that make him a perfect fit for the direction our program is heading in. Any roster would love the addition of Nick O.C. onto their squad, and we are thrilled to have his commitment towards us here at Franklin Pierce.
My name is Nicholas Oliveri Chase. I'm a defensive end at Cambridge Latin. I'm from Cambridge, Massachusetts. My intended major is communications. The reason I chose Franklin Pierce University is because from the moment I stepped foot on campus, I feel like everybody made me feel like home. From the coaches to just the faculty, everyone there. I'm born and raised in New England, so you know, I like that I get to be close to everything I know. And I'm bringing a winning attitude to the program. I'm looking forward to putting in work with the guys, putting in work with the coaches, and win some championships.
Colin Kroger, 6'2", 250, D-lineman out of Countryside High in Florida. He is a flat-out dog. Kroger has the habit of disrupting and making plays in the backfield. He embraces being physical at the point of attack, and his love for the game makes us very excited to have him here in Renz, New Hampshire.
Hi, my name is Colin Kroger, defensive end from Countryside High School in Clearwater, Florida. I plan to be a business major once I get up there. I chose FPU because I loved what Coach Gass is building up there, and I think we can go win any 10 championships within the next few years. FPU is getting a guy who leads on the field with his actions and intensity, and I just love the game of football.
Ashton Lively, 6'3", 270-pound offensive lineman out of Orange High School in New Jersey. Ashton is an athletic offensive lineman who's shown the ability to play guard and tackle. He's a versatile offensive lineman that keeps his feet moving upon contact and finishes defensive linemen and linebackers alike into the ground. We're excited about Ashton and his future here with the Ravens.
Hello, my name is Ashton Lively. I'm from Orange, New Jersey. I attend Orange High School. I play guard and center. My intended major is business. I chose Franklin Pierce because of former staff and me feel at home. The campus is beautiful, student body is diverse, and the education is outstanding. In regards to the program, I will bring dedication, commitment, work ethic, and perseverance. FPU is getting a dog. I'm always willing to work hard and give 110%.
Jacob Delgado, 6'2", 265-pound offensive lineman out of Springfield Central in Massachusetts. Like I said, Jacob comes from Springfield Central, which is a perennial power in Massachusetts. He's obviously been coached up, and he played with great technique. The thing we like about Jacob is his ability to play with a mean streak. We like his attitude, and that's evident on film. Jacob was a joy to be around on his visit, and we're excited that he's a Raven.
Hello, I'm Jacob Delgado from Springfield, Mass., home of the Eagles at Central High. I'm on the O-line, whether that be right guard or center. I want to major in criminal justice. I chose Franklin Pierce because there is a sense of community, educational success, and opportunity to play my sport. I believe that a team that fires on all cylinders shows unity and great chemistry. I'll bring hype, power, and more importantly, great camaraderie amongst the team. Go Ravens.
Hunter E., 6'4", 270-pound offensive lineman out of Belchertown High School in Belchertown, Massachusetts. Hunter has played both offense and defensive line for his high school. But for us, we really play on the offensive line. Hunter, for us, he has great length, and he has the capability of playing multiple positions within the offensive line. And so we're excited about his versatility, and we're excited that he's ready.
Hi, my name is Hunter Engler, and I'm from Belchertown, Massachusetts. I currently attend Belchertown High School, and I am an offensive and defensive tackle. I also play center and nose guard. My intended major is pre-med. I chose Franklin Pierce University because it's a small campus, a tight-knit community, and it's in a very beautiful area. It's overall perfect for me. I'm going to bring an aggressive player to the field and a dedicated player on and off the field.
Jalen Bynes, 6'1", 235, edge rusher from Notre Dame High School in New Jersey. Jalen is a natural pass rusher who fits well in our 3-4 system. He can play a multitude of spots for us, either putting his hand on the ground or standing up and putting pressure on opposing quarterbacks. Jalen is also a high school wrestler that will bring toughness and a lunch pail mentality to our program. Any 10 quarterbacks will be introduced to Jalen sooner than later.
My name is Jalen Bynes. I come from Trenton, New Jersey. I went to Notre Dame High School, and I played D and linebacker. I plan to major in sports management, and I chose FPU because I feel the coaching staff has a plan to bring FPU to the top, and I plan to bring my competitiveness, versatility, and creativity to the program.
Tyquan Stokes, 5'11", 205, linebacker from Paramus Catholic High School in New Jersey. Tyquan is an explosive defensive playmaker who has a nose for the ball. He brings speed and athleticism to our defense, providing us with great flexibility. Tyquan has a natural ability to get off blocks and instincts to diagnose plays quickly to limit opponents' backfields.
Hello, my name is Tyquan Stokes from Brooklyn, New York. I go to Paramus Catholic High School in New Jersey. I play linebacker, and I tend to major will be sports management. It's FPU because of the culture and the environment. The school has such a great support system. They support you 100% in everything you do, and that's just something that I really love and want to be a part of also. The type of player FPU is getting is a hard-working player who is quick and decisive, who loves to find the best solution to fix any issues we have on and off the field. I'm 100% focused, and I take full responsibility in anything that I do. With that being said, let's fly.
We have Jade Cologne, 5'9", 150-pound wideout from Manchester High School in Manchester, Connecticut. We like Jade because he's dynamic. He can definitely make plays when the ball is in his hand. We need a receiver like that, and we have one in him. As you can also see, he possesses the ability to return kicks, so he'll be an immediate impact on our return game and our special teams, and that's another great thing about him. I can't wait to coach him. He's a great kid. I enjoyed his presence on campus when he came up, him and his family, on his visit. And like I said, I'm glad he's on our team.
Jane Cologne. I'm from Manchester, Connecticut, and I'm an athlete from Manchester High School. I chose Franklin Pierce University just because of the amount of love and support that I got from the coaches and the guidance counselors. It's also some place that I can see to be my home. What I plan to bring to this program and what I will bring to this program is my leadership, my win mentality, my violence on the football field, and a championship ring.
Next, we have Terrence Ivey Jr., 6'2", 170-pound wideout from Green Oaks, Louisiana. And, I mean, you see why we like Terrence on his first clip. The kick can absolutely fly. He brings the ability to stretch the field for the Ravens, and he with a big frame, he makes it tough for defenders to cover him, you know, down the field. He said he wanted to race me when he get to school. I think I'll win that race. That's up to him. We'll have to find that out later. But, I mean, the kid is special, and I just can't wait to get him on campus. Can't wait to he becomes one of the Ravens, one of the Raven wideouts, and help us next season.
My name is Terrence Ivey Jr., and I'm from Dallas, Texas. I currently play football at Green Oaks Performing Arts in Shreveport, Louisiana. I plan on majoring in rank management, and I also chose FPU because of the instant connection with the coaches. I can tell during the recruiting process that it will be a great fit also. I'll bring passion, commitment, and dedication. Again, a player that's going to give you everything I have and more on and off the field.
Connor Garland, 5'11", 180 pounds, defensive back from Xavierian Brothers. Connor is a dangerous return man with the ability to take the ball end zone to end zone. He has the vision to see the hole, the patience to let it develop, and the burst to get through and take it the distance. He'd be a great addition to our special teams unit. Defensively, he has a knack for getting to the ball. He has great hands for a defensive back, so be careful throwing the ball in his direction.
Hey, FPU, I'm Connor Garland, and I'm from Waymouth, Massachusetts. I play defensive back for Xavierian Brothers High School. I plan on following the pre-med track at FPU. I chose track with this because I want to be a part of what Raven Nation is building. What kind of player am I? I'm the kind of player that will never be a mock draft from because I hate winning and more than I love winning. I'm absolutely excited to be joining FPU. Go Ravens.
Hello, Raven Nation. This is Coach Washington, offensive coordinator at Franklin Pierce University. I can't express how excited our staff is to be able to put together the signing class that we've put together this year. I think we were able to address certain areas of need on our team. Going back to the fall semester, our team was able to come together and have fully padded practices, and that aided in the growth and development of the current roster that we have. But here we are on signing day, and we're yet again adding to our roster with the addition of some offensive linemen, some receivers, some defensive linemen, some linebackers, and secondary as well. But offensively, we were able to address some areas of need for us, and the area of need for us was speed and athleticism. And I think we were able to accomplish that with the receivers that we signed and the offensive linemen that we got into our team as well. I can't wait. We're excited for the players that we signed to join us this summer and add to what we're doing here in Ravens football. Congratulations once again to all that have signed, and go Ravens.
Good afternoon, folks. This is Coach Ewan, the defensive coordinator and linebackers coach here at Franklin Pierce. First off, I want to just congratulate all the guys that are going to be joining the Raven football family this year. It's been a fun, interesting process throughout the last 6 to 8 months, and with all you guys' hard work over the last few years, you guys should be congratulated. As a defense this year, we're extremely proud of our guys, how they've developed. Over the past year, we've really put an emphasis on being bigger, stronger, more physical in our defensive front. We added some more young guys in last year's class that are going to add defensive playmakers to our group. Over the fall here, we've been able to get guys here, especially our young guys, to learn our system, learn our techniques with the additions of our coaches, Andre Evans in our secondary, and Jay Wyatt at our defensive line. We're really taking the next step with our group to be a competitive defense in the A-10. Again, just breeding the brand of being physical and getting guys and getting hats to the ball. Again, I want to congratulate the guys that are going to sign with us this year. We, like Coach said, we decided that we were going to go out and be defensive front oriented. We needed some more playmakers that were going to make the linebackers and second level job a lot easier. The three guys that we signed that are true defensive linemen are guys that are going to come in our league and certainly be competitive in their initial year. And we hope that they're going to be dominant defensive playmakers here in the near future. We also signed another guy who we think is versatile in what he can do. He really creates a lot of natural pass rush off the edge, which is something that our defense is predicated off, being a 3-4 fire zone team. We're going to be able to utilize some different packages at different spots, whether it's at some stand-up outside linebacker, defensive end, things like that, where he can just kind of wreak havoc in the backfield. We've also been able to sign an inside linebacker that we felt like we were missing. We felt like we lacked a little bit of athleticism there at that spot. We went right out and got a guy that we think is going to be able to run things down and really just be a ball hawk in our front seven and be able to go tackle everything that moves. So we're really excited about the additions to our defensive front again. Just trying to make sure that our defense understands that we're going to be a physical run-stopping team first and take the ball away when it's in the air. We're really looking forward to our signees in the secondary. We knew we needed to go out and find a couple guys that could go take the ball away, like I just said. And we feel like we've done that with this class. I'm really excited. Unfortunately, though, we did not get a chance to play this fall or this spring traditional games. I am really excited to continue the development of our defense, our program, for the fall of 21, where we can finally go out and compete and show what we've been able to work on for the last year. I think this time has been really beneficial for our program and especially our defense and our development. And like I said, I just cannot wait to go out there and see where we're at compared to the rest of the league. So again, congratulations, guys, and go Ravens.